Hi, this is Lisa McCormick, and in this mini lesson, I'm going to show you how you can create a situation where you can safely hang your guitars and other string instruments on the wall, up and out of harm's way, easy to reach at any time you want to play. And this is very low cost, do-it-yourself job. For this project, you'll need some of these utility hooks. I got these at the hardware store for under $2 a piece or so. And I think they're originally designed for hanging shovels and rakes and stuff on your garage wall. But they can also work really well for hanging a guitar or other string instrument on your wall, provided that you do it in such a way that they are able to safely support the weight. The other thing you'll need is a trim board. This is about a 1x3 trim board. I actually bought this at the salvage yard for just about $1, but you can also get a trim board at, at the lumber yard or the hardware store. First thing you want to do is cut your trim board to the length that is appropriate for the space you're going to hang it, and then paint the board. And I chose to paint the board with the same color as my wall color because I really wanted to just sort of blend right into the wall as much as possible. Once the paint is dry, you want to mount the trim board to the wall. And here's where you want to make sure you do things safely and correctly. If you have a stud and sheetrock wall, you want to make sure that you've located the studs in the wall and that you're screwing that trim board right into the wood, not directly into the sheetrock, because that can't hold the weight of the instruments. Myself, I have an old plaster and lath wall, so I just pre-drilled several holes and screwed it in using sheetrock screws, making sure that the board really grabbed onto the wall in several places so it's a good secure fit. Next, I mounted the utility hooks to the board, and just to make sure that they are far enough away from each other that the guitars don't bump into each other, I put a little spackle over the screws, and once that's dry, sand it down so it's smooth, and then just touch up the paint where the screws have gone in. I also put a little bead of acrylic clear colored caulk between the board and the wall so that I could paint a nice even line in there so it doesn't look as much like there's a board screwed to my wall. It looks a little more built in. And that's basically it. Now I can reach any of these guitars at a moment's notice, and yet they're up and out of harm's way. Oops, I guess there's a banjo in there too.